Lemonade.
My first son was born in Jersey. However, I was cloned by Clonate in Canada. My model number is 0112568, if anyone wants to see the registration and Clonate.
Here is the CEO and founder of Clonate.
Today is Bridget Boisselier, who is scientific director for a private company called Clonate. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for the invitation.
Sure. Tell us first what Clonate is and what the company is working on right now.
Okay, so Clonate is a private company. We founded that 4 years ago, got the funding to really have that last August. And so now we have three scientists working almost full-time in a lab here in the United States with the major goal for us to produce a human embryo by human cloning.
She is also a member of Raelism, which is a UFO religion. Here you can see the logo, and within it is the swastika and the six-pointed star. Where have we seen those before? More patterns. Raelism teaches that an extraterrestrial species, known as the Elohim, created humanity with advanced technology. These Elohim created 40 human hybrids that have served as prophets to disclose the human origin. They claim these prophets are Buddha, Jesus of Nazareth, and Muhammad. They also believe that when Jesus returns, it will be his clone. Raelians call their approach scientific creationism, otherwise known as intelligent design, with efforts to push human cloning. In 2005, George W. Bush said that he believes intelligent design should be taught in all schools. In the book, Family of Secrets, The Bush Dynasty, Russ Baker confirms the existence of more than one version of Bush Jr. It has been said that there are 14 versions of him, all birthed by surrogate mothers, that would be able to replace Bush if he were ever to go insane or die. Even David Letterman joked about it and pointed out how his nose always looks different. Pretty strange.
My understanding is that a lot of presidents have already been replaced.
That's right.
Yeah, like,
I don't think
they're
walking around.
They look old, but they basically
I'll give you something to ponder. Get some old videos of George Bush, when he first came into office. Look at the person and listen to him speak. Look at his actions and listen to his everything that there. Now it's a lot easier to put somebody out in front to act as a, you know, even Bush did. He had somebody else that was up there. Acting like he doesn't look like it. Even Hitler had he had his stand. In fact, his stand-in was the one that they found in the ground over in Germany.
Speaking of presidents, Freeman Fly proposed the interesting theory that Obama was the clone of Akhenaten, and Michelle Obama was the clone of his wife, Nefertiti. In the book, The Seven Clones of Barack Obama, occultist author Ben Zamagos discusses Obama as the spawn of an Anunnaki breeding experiment in order to bring back Akhenaten.
And you have to realize that there's more than one Obama.
Okay.
They're clones.
All right. Well, it would take a lot
No, and you think I'm kidding you. I'm serious.
Okay.
You when you see the clone can sing and dance. Yeah.
He can't see.
And whenever you see his wife with the clone, she is like on a bad date. She's very standoff. Her inner kids.
Like, she doesn't like him.
But the real Obama, they're always hugging him, close to him, kissing him, brushing the dandruff off, because he has dandruff. He really does. That's why I did that commercial for whatever that shampoo was. No, but seriously. You think I'm kidding. Watch them, okay? Even the little dog, the real Obama, the little dog's all up in their face. But the little dog is barking at the clone all the time.
While promoting Jumanji, Jack Black was asked about doing a sequel. He said, "There is no choice. You have to do the sequel. Otherwise, they will kill you and clone you." You could argue he was joking, but why was this video removed from the internet? And shortly after this interview, Kevin Hart, who was promoting the same movie, admitted to being a clone.
How do you do it? I look on Twitter. There you are. Facebook. There you are. Television. There you are. How do you do it?
I have a clone.
I was gonna say that there's two of you.
Cats out the bag. Okay, it's about a good three of me. We broke it. They didn't want to release it yet. This is major news that I'm giving you. I'm cloned.
Okay, I appreciate it.
That's why I'm able to do all that I do.
And then there was Holly Madison, former Playboy playmate who once was the main girlfriend of Hugh Hefner and the star of the reality show, The Girls Next Door. There used to be a video online of her talking about being a clone, and of course it was scrubbed. Holly once said, "I don't get jealous of other girls because I was raised in a cloning lab to be the perfect woman for Hugh Hefner. So other than the fact that my IQ is probably a little higher than he would like, I have nothing to worry about." Remember the media-frenzied paternal debate between Howard K. Stern and Larry Burkhead over who was Danny Lynn's real father? Frederick Prinz von Anhalt, who is the biological son of Adolf Hitler, came forward to claim that he was the real father.
The paternity battle quickly morphs into a bizarre spectacle when Zsa Gabor's husband, Prince Frederick von Anhalt, holds a press conference to declare he may be Danny Lynn's biological father.
"Well, I can tell you they are not a father. When you go out very often till 4 o'clock in the morning and you need people, you do something, things you don't even know the next day what you did."
How much weirder can this get? I'm telling you, they keep these bloodlines hidden. The film Boys from Brazil is about a cloning expert who implants numerous surrogates with Hitler's sperm in hopes that they will turn out just like the original Hitler.
"Well, our scientists have learned how to make people. They call them synthetics. Are you familiar with those? Well, it's a synthetic. A synthetic's when you touch their skin, it feels like plastic almost. That's the latest technique. The old techniques, if you guys can rent a video, The Boys from Brazil, rent it, because in it, it gives you the exact way how our government's been making people."
Really?
The movie Boys from Brazil was written by Ira Levin. He was an American novelist whose book centered around exposing Satanism, the occult, human cloning, and ritual murder. He also wrote Rosemary's Baby and The Stepford Wives. Spoiler alerts ahead. The 1975 film, The Stepford Wives, is centered around a Manhattan family who decides to move to the suburbs in hopes of a safer life for their children. The father joins a secret society where all the male members have killed and cloned their wives in order to program them to their liking. The main character, Joanna, meets Bobby, and they become fast friends. They gossip about how bizarre all the women in town act, and they form a women's liberation group to try to wake them all up. The plan backfires, and Joanna discovers that Bobby has been killed and cloned. When Joanna realizes she is next, she tries to escape with her kids. The movie ends with Joanna shopping at the grocery store, smiling and acting robotic. And as she passes her old friend Bobby, they politely greet each other, engage in a short, superficial exchange, and go about their day. And it is at that point we know Joanna was killed and cloned. They always say writers write what they know. What did Ira Levin really know? Jeffrey Peterson is an American tech pioneer who created the Latin social media site, K-Pasa. He is a Democrat and is very well connected through politics and Hollywood. In August of 2018, he started tweeting a number of threads about human cloning. They have all been removed, but I found and saved an archive of his old tweets. "This is not a joke. I said I will never lie to you, and I will not. I clearly overheard it, and I could see that others who were there were also uneasy. I know what I heard. They are doing real life experiments with cloning on remote islands. This is truth. What I heard that evening at the event where I had been invited was not improper for me to hear. Very clearly, loud and clear, that top personalities associated with the US Democrat Party are very involved in experimentation with cloning of biological beings." His second thread, which appeared a year later in 2019, discussed a conversation he overheard between Nancy Pelosi and John Sperling about a remote cloning project. Jeff Bezos was not there, but they were talking about him. And Nancy Pelosi kept saying, "He's doing mine. He's doing mine."
I preface it by saying, as you probably saw, there are military on the steps of Lincoln Memorial. What is it?
And remember this crazy video of Hillary Clinton?
We just cut right.
Whoa,
You guys have got to try the cold chai.
In 2015, Hillary Clinton was on Another Round podcast, and she was asked what the weirdest thing about her was. She replied by saying, "I don't sweat." And then she said this.
"You guys are the first to realize that I'm really not even a human being. I was constructed in a garage in Palo Alto
this
a very long time ago.
Tell
people think that, you know, Bill Gates and Steve Jobs, they created
it. They don't even know.
Oh, no. I mean, a man whose name shall remain nameless created me in his garage.
Are there more of you?
Now, I thought he threw away the plans. At least that's what he told me when he programmed me, that there would be no more. I've seen more people that kind of don't sweat and other things that make me think maybe they are part of the new race that he has created, the robot race.
So there's a cyborg
army. But I don't, you know, you got to cut that. You can't tell anybody this. I don't want anybody to know this. I mean, this has been a secret until here we are in Davenport, Iowa, and I'm just spilling my, you know, electronic guts to you."
What a strange thing to say. And who was this mystery man? Some believe that man is Jack Parsons. Jack Parsons was an American rocket engineer, chemist, occultist, and a member of Aleister Crowley's OTO. The OTO is a secret society where you are able to rise to the top through a series of ritual dramas and sex magic rituals. Believe it or not, this group still exists today. In the book Satan's Children by Rebecca Scott, she claims that Jay-Z and Beyonce are high-ranking members of the OTO and have performed a series of sex magic rituals. I will not go into the sordid details of what they have done with other men, but I will say that the name of their daughter, Blue, was a nod to the Blue Bloods, the black nobility families. In 1946, Parsons conducted a sex magic ritual called Babylon Working, a series of rituals to invoke the goddess Babylon to earth. Babylon is otherwise known as the Scarlet Woman. The symbol of the Scarlet Woman is the red dress. In Jack Parsons' personal memoir, he wrote that with assistance from Aleister Crowley and NASA, they conducted the 11-day experiment at the start of 1947. It was written that their goal was to birth a female child who would end up being on the world stage as a dominant feminist to transform humanity and usher in the New World Order. If you fast forward 9 months later in 1947, you have the birth of Hillary Rodham Clinton on October 26, 1947. She is the only woman alive today who has been in the public eye as a leader and a former presidential candidate. And remember, they never thought she would lose. It has been rumored that she will appear again to run in 2020 to claim the throne for which she believes is all hers. The HBO series Westworld takes place in 2058, depicting a simulated amusement park operated by the company Delos. Westworld is populated by human clones that are controlled by a powerful artificial intelligence. The members of this elite club can fulfill any desire they wish, including violence, murder, and rape of the clones. Kinda sounds like Donald Marshall's cloning center. Is this art imitating life? Westworld also brings to mind Jeffrey Epstein's Zorro Ranch in New Mexico, where he was creating a breeding farm. Did you know that Joe Biden owns a parcel of land on Water Island, right next to Epstein Island?
Even Hitler had he had his stand-in. In fact, his stand-in was the one that they found in the ground over in Germany. I mean, Hitler and Eva and the dog and 14 other people got aboard a plane and flew down to Barcelona, Spain. You were aware of that. And then ended up in Antarctica or in Swabenland and then died a few years ago in Brazil.
Did you know that the Rothschilds own an island in Antarctica? Why did George Green say that Hitler went to Antarctica? Kinda makes sense now that we know Hitler was a Rothschild. And remember when Vice asked, how far off are we from digital clones of Black Mirror?
I was like, that's amazing. I've been trying to explain to people that, and it's because it's really different. It's not de-aging, right? So it's not my face and they just made it look younger. It's a 100% digital character. It's the first ever 100% digital human. So I didn't see any of that. It was 8 months before I saw the scenes, and when I saw me and my new digital clone. It was spectacular. It was actually a little freaky.
Conversation about clones right now. Is that what we're doing right now?
Do you ever met a clone?
This is a.
Have I met a clone? Yeah, I think I met some clones.
See?
Really?
This clone's a
cells off of your body, yours. We give them a small electrical charge. I'm just act like a fertilized egg. If I got a fertilized egg, all I need is a receiver in order to make it. So they were hypnotizing women, you know, said they were being invaded by aliens. And the fetus starts growing, right? Needs food. Well, they can use cows and sheep too. Again, a food source, that's all we need. After about 14 weeks, all of a sudden that fetus is gone. Because they've learned to take, that's when the fetus starts developing its own blood supply. Then they've used a pituitary hormone extract that they have, which accelerates the being that grows. And the original technology was given to our government by the Greys.
What did I just watch? And then I found this bizarre website called twinstrangers.net. You can find your doppelganger instantly. You can even set up a meet and greet with your twin. Then there are the celebrity look-alike photos. What is this? Can somebody please explain? The internet is even saying that Derek Chauvin, the cop who killed George Floyd, has a clone. We've all heard the terms the Great Awakening and the event, and we all believe we are living in the end times, but we don't know what any of this really means. There is a Twitter account who goes by the name Kabomber, who claims that the Galactic Federation missed certain opportunities in 2016 to trigger the event, and that is why QAnon went into full effect in 2017. He claims that a parallel Earth has been created, and we will all shift into the new timeline on April 2nd, 2021, 11 p.m. Eastern Time. Pretty specific. All of those who shift will essentially travel backwards in time to this date. Immediately upon shifting to the new Earth, the entire population will be ready to meet their galactic families, will have a new body, and gain amazing abilities. He also says there will be people who will be left behind. Kabomber claims to get his messages from the Pleiadians. According to the book Dulce Wars, there is a federation of space worlds based in the Andromeda and Pleiades constellations, including aliens from Sirius B, who have severed ties with the Ashtar Collective, which was infiltrated by the Orion-based reptilians and Greys. The Pleiadians warn that the rebel angels are now controlling the infiltrated segment of the Ashtar Command and are masquerading as Ascended Masters. So, if this is true, how do these so-called channelers even know who they are talking to? This was written in 1999. Fast forward to 2018, and Kabomber is claiming that President Trump has traveled on Pleiadian crafts and has even left Earth. He also claims that Q is the Pleiadian soul of Ortiq, who once incarnated on Earth as Abraham Lincoln and JFK. Remember all those strange coincidences between Lincoln and JFK? Kabomber claims that Ivanka Trump is the twin soul of Ortiq, the reincarnation of Lincoln and JFK. JFK's memorial is also shaped like a Q, and Kabomber claims that if the event doesn't happen as predicted in 2021, Ivanka will go on to become president. The event is described many times in the Bible. Matthew 24:40 through 41 reads, "Then two men will be in the field. One will be taken and the other left. Two women will be grinding at one mill. One will be taken and the other left." Luke 17:24 reads, "I tell you, on that night, two people will be in one bed. One will be taken and the other left." Corinthians 15:51 through 53 reads, "Listen, I tell you a mystery. We will all not sleep, but we will all be changed in a flash, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, the dead will be raised imperishable, and we will be changed." Thessalonians 4:16 reads, "After that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever." Even The Simpsons predicted the event. If you have ever wondered why our parents lie to us about Santa, you must understand that this is the most profound lesson we will ever learn. The deception of Santa teaches you that you can't trust anyone or anything. The human experience is riddled with disappointment, lies, and deceit. We need the lies to see the truths. We need the deceit to see the good, and we need the patterns to trust our instincts. But how do we know what is real and what is truth? Is Q real? Are the Pleiadians real? How are we supposed to know? Are the reptilians and gray aliens cloning us underground? Are the celebrities trying to let us know? Is Donald Trump working with the Pleiadians, and is Donald Marshall's story really legit? Or is this all just another psyop that started long, long ago to program us into accepting the idea of space and aliens to bring in a new world order? Is all the madness in the world right now preparing us for something much bigger, like the anticipated event? Overall, it seems like it would be a pretty big psyop employed by many people over many years, and I just ask myself, how can it all work so seamlessly, yet remain so confusing? It seems to me that the military-industrial complex is extremely compartmentalized and so divided, it is totally impossible to know what is real. Do we trust our whistleblowers, or are they paid shills pushing disinformation at us? How do we even know what books are real, or movies, or stories, anything we consume? In 2020, we all know that the news is fake, and we know that they do not want us to know the truth. So this pushing of the New World Order just makes sense every time I turn on the news. It's just filled with lies and deceit. And my conclusion is still the same. No one knows, but we can connect the dots, trust our gut, and have our own opinions. And maybe instead of searching for answers externally and looking to other people for the truth, maybe the true answer is just to stop. Stop looking, stop searching, and stop worrying, and just live. I will leave you with that to do your own critical thinking. Until then, stay safe out there, and don't stop questioning the world around you.
So if that doesn't shake things up for you a little bit, I don't know what will. I hope you guys enjoyed that video. Check out Amy on YouTube. I think she just restarted her channel, so she needs some new subscribers and exposure and such. And yeah, take care of yourselves. Stay healthy and happy. And we'll see you in the next one.